Welcome back to the Shtick. We have in the studio with us Richard Moore.
Hello, Shtickers. Hello, Henry.
Hi. We've just seen a little trailer of the AICE Israeli Film Festival.
Yep, pretty good festival. This year, new dates. It's at Sydney at the Rambic Ritz, Nova in Melbourne, and 16 films, all in competition for a new prize, $25,000. Big prize. It opens with Firebirds. Here we are, I've got the program here. Aren't I a good publicist? It opens with Firebirds, which is a great Holocaust mystery drama with some real veterans of stage and screen. Oded Tomei, Devorah Kedar, and Gila Almagor, all starring in a great drama. I think very entertaining. I think people will enjoy very much. Great opening. Nice to open with an upbeat film.
I'll be there for the opening.
Good.
And I've got lots of other things on that night, but I'm going to come because I love the films you show. You've got some fantastic films in the program. Mm.
And you'll have drinks and canapes as well.
I know. Well, that's mainly why I'm coming.
Yeah, I think so. That's why I go.
And you also have a little bit of music in the foyer sometimes. Are you doing that this year?
No, we'll see this year, yeah.
I like that.
Might be me.
A bit of jazz. You?
It might be me.
I didn't know you did music.
No, I used to play piano, but I gave it up. I should start again.
You should.
Yeah, I should. I know. Yeah. What other films? Do you want to know about the other films?
Yeah, there's one or two others. There's Keep Quiet, which I think is a really amazing story.
Keep Quiet is the amazing story of the Hungarian far-right politician Susnad Szigeti. I think I got his name right. And he was the far-right leader of a Jobbik party, basically the Hungarian sort of paramilitary fascist organisation, who are anti-Semite, who denounced the Holocaust. Pretty nasty bunch of people. And the film is basically him discovering the fact that he was brought up as a Christian. His parents didn't tell him that he was Jewish. He basically discovers or is told that his identity is Jewish and suddenly finds himself without a lot of friends. Ah. But the interesting part of it is sort of a two-hander because he forms a friendship with Rabbi Oberlander. He goes to Rabbi Oberlander, who's the son of a Holocaust survivor himself, Hungarian, but living in New York, rabbi, wisecracking sort of New York rabbi. And the rabbi decides to take him on and turn him into an Orthodox Jew, which he does. The question throughout the film is whether you actually believe the guy. Do you believe that this is a real act of penance, that someone who had spouted such vicious anti-Semitic material could suddenly turn around and become an Orthodox Jew? He's now planning on making Aliyah to Israel. It'll be interesting to see how he's received. How he's received there. Hello, welcome.
We need to look at the forgiveness. There is a certain amount of forgiveness, like we had March of the Living. You go back to Poland and to the thing, and you've got to have this sense of you've got to really let go of the past and look at the new person that you are, or the new vista.
That's right.
What's really going on the ground? There's another film called Everything is Broken Up and Dances, which is a rock and roll film, isn't it?
Yeah, Everything is Broken Up and Dances is made by a young group. Noni Geffen is the director, a young group of people in Tel Aviv. And it's a sort of like a post-traumatic syndrome war film. Mm. But it's so the main character is, his armored tank is hit by a Hamas missile. He has to recover. He has a lot of problems recovering. But his process of recovery is very strange. He does it through music and through sort of inhabiting the spirit of his uncle, who was a wannabe musician. And he turns into this grunge rock star in Tel Aviv. He becomes the thing, and everybody loves what he's doing.
But underneath it all, he's completely smashed.
Completely. His whole psyche is completely smashed up, but he finds his way through art, through music. So it's sort of like a positive story in the end. Well, I won't tell you what happens in the end because it would spoil it for you, but Everything is Broken Up and Dances. That's a good one to see.
And Harmonia, what's that about?
Harmonia is a new film. It's funded by the Gesher Fund, who are a fund, Jerusalem Tel Aviv, who are funded to do, who do many, many different things. But this is to do new biblical interpretations of biblical stories.
Oh, yes.
And it's the story of
Abraham and Ishmael and Sarah and Hagar. Yeah.
That's right. And it's set in Jerusalem.
Set in today's terms in the the biblical underlying story.
Yep. And set inside a Philharmonic Orchestra in Jerusalem, the two children, the two different sides working across one side of Jerusalem and the other side of Jerusalem. Mm. They're beautiful. Lots of music, of course, in it.
What a dichotomy.
Yeah.
It is, isn't it?
Well, it is. And, you know, the whole program is like full of so many, you know, contradictions and so many opposite sort of styles of films. There's romantic comedies. There's tough, hard-hitting documentaries like Town on a Wire, which is set in the city of Lod, which is when the Israelis had to appoint a mayor, a wonderful man. I met him in Tel Aviv when I was there for Doc Aviv earlier this year in May. Mm-hmm. And he has to come in and he has to bring together the two sides, the Muslim and the Jewish side, to try and basically make peace in the city, because in Lod it was like really bloody dangerous to move around in Lod. And the meanwhile, outside, while they're trying to fix all the internal problems, all the drug lords are shooting each other, the whole thing. It's very dramatic. It's a cut down of a TV series that did very well in Israel.
And we're going out with that because we've reached the end of our time, Richard Moore.
Okay.
And we're going to go out with the trailer of this fantastic film, Town on a Wire. And if anybody wants to go to the Israeli Film Festival, there's a website where you can book. And I think your lineup of films is sensational.
Thanks, Henry. Yeah. And come along, everyone.
It's been great to have you on. And we'll be back next week with more Shtick. Until then, we're going to wish you shalom. And just say shalom.
Shalom.
מתחילת השנה נתפסו בעיר לוד 17 מטעני חבלה,
פצוע אחד,
שני טילי לאו, 8 רובים ו13 אקדחים. בונקר של ממש.
אחי אמר לי, כל החברים שאתה רואה פה בשכונה שלך, עוד 20 שנה או כולם מתים או כולם בכלא.
לא רוצה להיות פה, אני חיה פה בפחד.
בעיר לוד אין דו-קיום.
תמיד יש כאלה שמשלמים את המחיר והם לא אשמים.
העיר לוד נמצאת לפני תפנית.
אם תל אביב פורחת, אין שום סיבה שלא תפתח.
מקווה שתעשו הלאה, ואני מתנדב יחד איתכם לגייס את התושבים לעשות אותו דבר.
זה מגלה מציאות חדשה.
עדיין אין אצבע על האל.
חזרתי להאמין בעיר הזו.
ההיסטוריה לא חשובה, חשוב מה עושים.